So it is 7 PM now. I think I am audible to all, and we have reached the time to start the session. That is 7 PM. So let me start the discussion and introduce yourself with Mr. Sandeep and Mr. Umesh. They are from Remketsis Private Limited. They will be explaining us about the Strap 2021 software and Vertex PT software that are used for light gauge steel design. As you can understand, light gauge steel design represents the cold form sections also, that is used mostly for PEB structures. So we are very much interested in this light gauge steel design and how the software can help us. That would be very interesting to see.
Okay, sure. Thank you, sir. So hello, all of you. This is Sandeep. I'm the technical support specialist for structural softwares in Remketsis Private Limited. Remketsis Private Limited is an institution, or you can say a company, who deals with different civil engineering software, starting from structural department, geotechnical department, and many other softwares that helps us to, to do our job very easily, which we'll be doing maybe manually or in some other way. So, today in this webinar, I'll be showing you the capabilities of Strap 2021 software as the tool for analysis and designing the LGSF, or you can say light gauge steel frame structures. So I will not take much of the time, and I will just begin the presentation. So I will just allow me to share my screen. I hope my screen is visible.
Yes, your screen is visible.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Thank you, sir. So here, this is actually, just let me show you the icons. This is the whole bunch of softwares, or you can say whole bunch of modules you can get from Strap software. It is a total Strap suite. So the software that I'm using now, this is the basic one, which is the Strap. So if I open this, first of all, you will find something like this. Here it is. Here you will find all the models or all the structures that you have created so far. And it will be having the date of modification, the number, and also you will have a preview of the structure. You can see whenever I'm clicking on different structure, it is giving me a preview of that structure. So it will be very easy for you to understand which structure you want to work on. Hello. And also you'll have some information about the model here. What type of model it is, how many beams and elements are there. So the basic information about your structure or about your model will be available here. So this is the model page, and here we have some tools to create, like different other softwares. You can create a new model, you can print this model, you can delete or copy from other folders. So these options are available here. So today I will start with a basic introduction, like how you can generate or you can create a model. What I will do, I will create a new model. So I'll click on this new model here. It will ask me to give a name to the model. So I will just give it a name, suppose demo001. Okay. Now you can set up the units here for your model. I'll be working on meters and kilonewtons, so I will just keep it like that, the title of the model, and what type of structure it is, whether it is a plane frame, that means 2D frame, or a grid, or a truss, or maybe a space frame. So for now, I will take space frame. Now, what we can do, we have model wizard also. If I click on this model wizard, you can see that a lot of structural models are available here that you can take and you can edit as per your requirement. But I will not take any of this for now. I will just cancel it. You can also create grid lines. As you know, in structures, we have grid lines, and accordingly, you can create your structure. Or you can click on this user defined. So to start from very, very scratch. So I will just click on this user defined. So you will have a window like this. So this is the user interface of Strap 2021 software. Here at the top, obviously, you will be having this model geometry to just change your, you can say, the interface for creating the geometry, for putting the loads or putting the weights, Okay, so different other options will be available once you have assigned everything. Then we have some of these options I'll be explaining while creating a model here. So you have this option for viewing the structure from different angle, to create different views, to check the rendered view of the model. So all these things I will be explaining later. So how to create a model here in Strap 2021? So it is completely based on nodes and elements, or you can say nodes and beams. So to create the nodes, you can see at the right hand side, you have all these options, nodes, restraints. So we don't have anything here, so it cannot go to restraints here, beams, elements, slabs. So step by step, things are there, things are given there. So first we need to create the nodes. So if I click on nodes now here, the tools to create or modify or delete any of the nodes present on your structure, it will be available here. Okay, so I will just use basic tools now. So you can see what you can create one by one the nodes. You can create nodes with equal distance, or you can create nodes with unequal distance. And these two will be combined here in the grid. Like you can create a grid of node with equal or unequal distance. So for now, I will use this option, grid. You can see it is asking you like whether you want equally spaced nodes or unequally spaced nodes. First, I will choose this one, equally spaced nodes. I will click on OK. And I will give the first point of the node, like first position of the node. So I will press Alt to keep it here, and I'll just keep the coordinate values as 0, 0, 0 for x1, x2, and x3. I'll press select here. So you can see one node we have created. Now it is asking you for the end node of this grid. Okay. So suppose the total length of this bay is suppose 15 meters. So I will just put it here. I will press Alt again. And here you can see this is the global axis, which is telling us that in which direction we are going. So it is x1 direction. So I will give the distance, you can see dx1 as 15 meter. Obviously dx2 and dx3 will be 0, and I will click on this select. Now it is asking, as it is a equally spaced, it will be, so how many divisions you want between these two nodes. So I have taken 15 meters. Suppose I want 5 divisions of 3 meter, right? So 5 divisions, click on OK. So now you can see it has created nodes with 3 meter distance up to 15 meters. Now again, for the other direction, you can again choose equally spaced or unequally spaced. I will just simply select this one, unequally spaced, click on OK. Now in the other direction, I will press Alt. Suppose I will go DX to maybe 20 meter. And I will click on select here. Now we need to give this unequal distances here. Okay, so the first distance, suppose I will give here DB. So the first distance is 5 meter. Yes, so at 5 meter distance, we have got one. So we have got, we are left with 15 meter, right? So I will again give maybe 4 meter. So 9, then maybe again 5 meter. So how much it is? 5, 4, 9 and 14, right? So again, maybe I will give here distance 6 meter and select here. So you can see it will end the creation of node because the end point was at 20 meter. So this is how you can create grid of nodes. And now if you want to create beams on using these nodes, so you just have to go to beams here. Again, the same options, you can create beams individually or you can create grid of beams. So first I will just show you how you can create individual beams. I will just click on define here. You can see we have three options, like split at intermediate nodes, if you want to split the beams at every intermediate node, or a chain of nodes, okay, or if you want to create an arc beam. So maybe I will just show you the first one like this. So it will create one beam like this. You can create beams like that. If you use this chain of beam, it will just continue the beam like this. Okay, so I'll just end the definition. So this is the way, like one by one, you can create the beams. So I will just press undo. Now, if you want to create a grid of beam, I will just go to grid. It will ask me to select the left end corner, this one, the right one, and the top one. and automatically you'll get a grid of B. So this is the way using which you can create any model, like the nodes, the using the nodes and beams, you can create any model. I will just show you one 2D model. I will go to my model list.
Yeah, Mr. Sandeep. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Just a second. Yeah, is directly from Excel, can we input the grid?
No, sir. Grids are not possible, but you can export the DXF files. Like if you create this
AutoCAD file.
Yeah, yes.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
Yeah, so if you see, you can see we have this DXF option, so you can convert the strap file to DXF or create a model from DXF file. You can do that actually. It is possible here. Okay, so I will just open a 2D model of a small wall. Okay. So you can see this wall. This is a wall panel made up of cold form steel sections. And so this wall also we have created using those grid of nodes and beams that I just showed, right? Now, these are just line elements and nodes. So what we have to do, we have to assign the properties on these line elements, right? We have to assign the beam property, or you can say whatever section we want. For that, as we are considering these line elements as beams here, so I will just go to beams here. And you can find a property option here. So if I click on property, you can see some of the properties are already defined. So if suppose you have created from the scratch and you want to assign a property, so what you have to do, just click on any unused property here. If you click on define or revise, now it will ask you to select the section type. So as we are talking about cold form steel, or you can say light gauge steel, so you just have to select cold form here and it will take you to the cold form sections. So I'll click on this steel table and you can see all the cold form sections are available, like C lips, CFS, angles, all this Z plus lips, Z sections, these are available. So if I define one C lips here, you can see we have a hell lot of sections here you can choose from here. Okay, so I will just choose maybe 89, 41.5, this one, click on OK. Major axis direction, you can select any of these and click on OK here. So this section will be defined here. Now, you just have to click on assign, whether you want to assign this section to individual beam. So if I click on individual beam, it will ask me to select any of these beams to assign this property. So it is very pretty simple. I will just cancel it because I've already assigned. So once you have assigned these sections, how you can identify like which sections I have assigned on which line element? It is pretty simple. Now these things will be helpful, this particular area. You can see we have this property number option here. If you click on this property number, it will show you the property number assigned on these line elements. So where you will be getting these property numbers, if you go to properties, you can see this property 1, 2, 3, 4, it is given here. So these are the numbers actually it is showing. And also for different properties, it is giving a different color so that you can just differentiate between different properties. And in properties, we can also create combined sections. Like just let me show you here. If I render it, you can see we have two plates, okay, two flat sections actually with a certain distance. But if you see in the finite element model or in the line model, it is just one single line. So what we have done, we have just created a combined section here. If you go to properties and you can see this flat, this is a combined section with two flat plates. Okay, to create this, if I click on unused property, define revise, here we have this option to create the combined section. Now, what type of section it is, if I cold form, so you just have to select like we have this flat plates, right? So you just have to select what type of section you want to create the combined section. And then it will ask you, suppose I will select any of these. Then it will ask you what type of, like how you want to join this back to back or front to front. And what will be the distance between these two sections? If you define this, it will be automatically created. Okay, So this is the way, like any type of section you want, you can create from here. It is available. So
that means all built up sections are categorized under combined sections.
Actually, combined section, suppose it is kind of like this only. Combined sections are, suppose you have two sections with a certain distance. These are combined sections, like we have here also. We have two C lips with
If I make a plate girder, so it will be as a combined section or will it be as a built up section?
Now you can create, like, it depends on how you have created. You can create using the combined option, or we have another module called CrowSec. If you create using that, it will consider a normal section only. So there are different methods. It's just one of the method available in Strap, actually.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. So as I'm talking about the sections, now suppose someone will be asking that one section is not available in the section list that is available in the Strap. So how can I assign that section? Or maybe some people want to join three CLIP sections for one column or for one vertical member. So how we can do that? So for that, for specially LJSF structures, we have another module, or any kind of structure, actually, you can do that. We have another module called CrowSec here, in which you can create your own cross sections. So let me just open this CrowSec. It's a pretty simple interface. There is nothing very, you can say, wide screen. So what I will be doing, I'll be creating as, you can say, user-defined section. For that, I will just go to section here and new line section. Just give it a name, suppose C-lips maybe. And the thickness I will consider 1 mm. Bend radius maybe 2. Click on OK. Now you can just draw randomly. There is like the, you do not have to worry about the dimensions and all. Just draw randomly whatever section you want. Suppose this is a C section. I'm not worrying about the dimensions of this section because we can edit this afterwards. And it is a pretty simple section which is already available in Strap. So what I will do, I'll just make it complicated. For that, I'll go to section again. I will add another subsection here with same thickness and bend radius. And maybe I will create it here. Okay. Let me add another one. Yeah, it is fine now. So just would give me a minute. 45, 41, 25. Okay. We'll just put these values A1 again. Similarly, A2, it will be 41. A3 will be 25. Again, A4 will be 41. A5 will be 25. Now the thickness and bend radius will be 1 and 2, as we have already considered. Similarly, A6 now, let's see what we have. A6, okay, the lips, so it will be 25 again. A7 will be 41. A8, this dimension, the depth will be 75. A9, again, this dimension, which is 41. 25, yeah. Again here, 25, 41, A8, sorry, A13, right? Where is A13? Yeah, the depth, so it is 75, 41, and 25. I think we are almost done giving all the parameters. Now you can create a number of sections here. Like once you have created the you can say template, You just have to put the parameters, or you can say put the dimensions here for these nomenclatures, and it will automatically create the section. And you can see here it has also calculated the section properties for that particular section, like the combined section. Okay, the moment if it is yes. So now I have created just one. I'll click on OK now. So after creating this, we have to export this to Strap, right? Otherwise we cannot use it. So for that, I will just go to section table, and here you can find an option called transfer to Strap. So I'll click on transfer to Strap. Which one? Obviously the bottom one, this one. This was the previous one, but I want this one, CLIPC. In which dimension, millimeters it was, and click on OK. So it will give you a message that one section were added to Strap cold form table. I'll click on OK. So now I will just close the Strap software, and I'll reopen it. I'll open this file. And now if I go to Beam and Properties, I will add any section, cold form, steel table. You can see this CLIPC that we have added, it is here. 75, 41, 25. This section is here now. So now you can assign it. I think we have given some random parameters for that. So maybe the section is not that much correct. But still, I will show you how. I'll just add this. You can select from here how you want to consider the direction of the major axis. Okay, section orientation, the major axis orientation, and click on OK. And you can assign it to any of the sections here. So I will assign it to this beam, and I can show you in the rendered view. So you can see the section that we have created here. I hope the section is pretty clear to all of you. The section is pretty visible to all of you. Okay, so this way you can create your own section here in Strap, and you can use it anywhere, wherever you want. Now I will just undo this. Okay.
Yeah, Mr. Sandeep, there is one query from my side that in CAD, when I was using the user defined section in for cold form, so it did not have a library in STAT Pro for section with lips. So I was using AutoCAD, and in AutoCAD I was drawing that section, and we can export that section to section designer or user defined section. So it was quite faster to draw in AutoCAD and then export it into STAT. I can make it in STAT also, and here also I think it is the same procedure. But is it possible to connect it with DXF also, the section designer?
No, sir. Actually, for the section, you must have this CROSEC module with you to create the sections, actually. For meetup sections,
If I want to make my own list of sections, let's say I have 20, 30 sections that I use for my industry, and I don't want to define it now and again, so it would be saved all the time in the section designer?
Yes. Suppose just now I have exported one, right? Now, suppose let me just change the model. I will open another model. Just give me one second. I have just opened another one. If I go to Beams Properties and define here, you can see the CLIPC is there already. So once you have created and exported to Strap, it will be available for you forever, unless or until you have deleted this. So you can use it anywhere, in any project. So it is not an issue. Is it your question, sir? Is that your question or your query was?
Yeah. So it is like every time I don't have to define a section. Once it is defined,
no. Once you have created, it will be saved.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, okay. So now I will go back to my previous model. Yeah, So once we are done with assigning the properties, now we have to assign the moment releases wherever we require. So to assign the moment releases, if I go to beam, we have this, you can see releases option. You can give the moment release to both ends or to maybe the selected ends of the member. You can also release the axial, you can see axial release option is there. You can make a beam as tension only, or you can make a beam as compression only. You can see these bracing members are tension only members that we have assigned to these bracing members. So as per your requirement, you can assign to any of the members as you want. Then suppose you have assigned the properties and I don't know whether the orientation of the members are correct or not. For that, we have this option here. If you see display section orientation. So if I click on this, it will show you the orientation. Now it is in 2D view, so it is showing like this. That the C, the face of the C is in this direction. It is actually meaning. If you want to just change the orientation, for that we have this local axis option. If you click on local axis, you can change this orientation. We have different, these options are unavailable because these options are will be used in the 3D panel. So it is a 2D panel, so we cannot use these options here. That's why these are not available here. So suppose I want to invert the flange location. So if I click on this invert flange location for this individual beam, so you can see it has just changed its direction. So for any other beam, you can do the same using this local axis. We have different options. This beta angle can be used in the 3D window actually. So for 2D, we have these options using which you can change the orientation of your member. So I will just undo this.
So there is X1 and X2 below.
Yes.
Yes. So this is global axis or local axis?
No, this is global axis actually. That is, I'm going to show you now. So the one you are seeing here, it is the global axis, X1 and X2. Now every single member has their, like if you want to check the member forces, it will be all about the local axis. The member forces will be given in terms of the local axis. So how to see the local axis? For that, if you click on this display all local axes, you can see the local axis is visible here. So the axial one, like which is along the direction of the member, the red one, the first local axis, and the second one is perpendicular to that. As it is 2D, so we have only two local axes. In the 3D model, you'll find three local axes actually. So according to that, we need to check the member forces. And if you want to see the displacements and support reactions, it will be all about the global axis. So these things we will see in a while. So I will just turn off this. So what we have done, we have created the nodes, beams, and we have assigned the section properties. We have assigned the releases. Okay, and we have also changed the location, the local axis direction or the orientation of the members. Now, the next process is to assign the restraints, or you can say the supports. So at the base, what I have done, I have assigned a pin support. If you go to restraints here, you have different options. We have fixed, pinned, other means you can assign by yourself, maybe roller support. So these, and you have rigid links. So these rigid links will be used in case of, if you want to assign, you can say rigid diaphragm to the structure. So this rigid link will be used in that case. So these options you can use to assign the restraint to your support. So here I have assigned pin support. So you can see here, this is the symbol. Now, after doing all this, we'll be going to the loads. So if I click on the loads here, now, same in the right hand side, we'll be having the options to define or modify the loads. So if you want to create, obviously it is very pretty simple. Anyone can see here, we have an option to create a new load. So I'll click on new load. You can give it a name, suppose dead load. And if you click on OK, now you are inside that dead load case. Now dead load can be in the form of beam load or in the form of global load. Okay. In the form of, you can say joint load, so you can assign accordingly. So what I will do, I will just end this load case and I will show you some existing load case that I have defined already. You can see we have the self weight of the structure. Now, how to define that self weight? For that, if I just modify the dead load I have defined, and suppose I will take the beam loads defined, you can see here we have uniform load, linearly varying load, concentrated loads, and here we have self weight. If you click on self weight, you don't have to calculate the self weight of the members. The software will take care of that. And any other load like you have different maybe the load from the top. So the wall loads, so you need to put using this uniform or linearly varying load, whatever you want. So, but the self weight, once you click on the self weight, it will be calculated by the software automatically. So here we have done this actually, existing load case. If I click on SW, that means the self weight. So you can see all the self weights are calculated automatically. Then these are the superimposed dead loads for the floor joists. Here, suppose this is a wall panel and it is a part of a 3D frame structure. So obviously at the top, we will be having the floors, and for that we will be having this floor joists to support the floor. So these are the just point loads on this beam at the location of the joist actually. So then we have the live load, same from the floor. Then we have assigned the wind load using the member load option, uniformly defined distributed load. Wind load from the other direction, and we have some combinations. Now, why we have created the combinations here in the load case itself? I will just tell you this in a while. Now, you can deactivate some loads if you want. See, here we have the tension only members, and in this wall panel, individual load will not work, right? Whenever you will be analyzing this structure, you want to see the analysis result for the combined action of dead load, live load, or wind load. So in that case, suppose you do not want to use this self weight, dead load, and live load individually. You want only the combinations of loads to give you the result. So what I have done, I have created a combination. You can see here, dead load plus live load, and we have dead load plus wind load in different directions. And what we have done, we have inactivated the other individual load cases. So this is totally up to you. You can deactivate or activate any of the load cases as per your requirement, and you can run the analysis. So here only the load combinations created here in the load case will be done. So I will click on end here. And here we have one option called sway. This I will explain later. We have this copy load option. Now, when you will be using this copy load, suppose you have defined this dead load here. Now, at the same place, you will be having the live loads, right? So it is a very hectic job to point out those locations again and assign these point loads. So what you can do, you can use this copy load option. If I click on this copy load, which load I want to copy, suppose this dead load. And here you need to click on this regular copy and copy here. I will just name it as maybe live load and click on OK. So I have created another load case copying the dead load. Now what you have to do, you just have to modify the values if the values are different. So I will click on this joint load as these are joint load, and I'll click on revise. Now you just have to click on any of the joint loads. So here I will click on this. You can see it has already taken the 1.8. So you can just change it to maybe 1.2. And I'll click on OK. Now it is asking whether you want to change the similar kind of loads present in this structure. So yeah, revise loads only at the selected node, or maybe revise loads at all highlighted nodes. So I want both of these loads to be changed. So I'll click on this one, revise loads at all highlighted nodes. So you can see here. So this is pretty easy. Rather repeating the task again and again, you just use this copy load option and you can revise these values. So I will just end this load case now, and I do not want to run these two load cases. So I will just inactivate this. And I will solve this load cases that I have created. So the analysis is done. Now you can see the results. If I go to this, you can see after analysis, automatically you are in the result tab. And here everything will be in the right hand side. Okay. So if you want to check the general results, if you click on this here, you will be having the options to check the general results. So if I click on this draw result option, you have different display type, displacements, and maybe the beam results diagram for load cases here. Like as I have told you here, I have created the load combinations in terms of load case. So again, we have these load combinations actually, which will be used for the design of the structure. So if I click on this load case and I want to check this result type M3, maybe result type I want in dashed and okay. So you can see for this dead load and live load, we are having this moment three means the major moment here on the top. If I change it to wind load, you can see on the columns also we are having this actually. Means the vertical members, not columns, the vertical members. If I change it to axial force, you can see the axial force. So this is how you can interpret the result. And if you just want to display table, and this kind of results you can also see in terms of table. So you can see maybe display results of elements, not or whatever support reactions. Maybe I will click on OK for which load case you want, maybe this one. So at every location, it will give you the support reactions in all the directions. So now how you'll understand which node number it is? Again, we have this here actually. So I will just close this. And if I click on this, you can see node numbering. So these are the node numbers actually. So you can identify using these node numbers at which node you are having the results. You can also have the beam number. These are the beam numbers. Okay. And if you are having plate, then you can also see the element numbers actually here. Okay. So the loading is done. We have got the results also. Now the next step is the design, right? So what you can do, you can click on this combination here and you can define your combination for the design. So if I click on define device, you can see it will give you a list of combinations. These are the names of the combinations. These are the load cases we have. So as we have created the load cases in terms of load combination, so we have just given the name of the combination and we have given the factors as one because the combinations are already defined there. Okay. So otherwise, what you can do, we have a bunch of combinations actually that you can retrieve. So if I go to combinations here, you can see standard combinations library. We have this library. If I click on retrieve from standard program library, now you can choose any code that you want. Maybe IS800. And what are the combinations you want? Dead load 1.5, dead load plus live load, or whatever combinations are available as per IS800. You can choose from here, or you can choose from AAC, ASD here. Any load combination you can choose from here actually. So suppose I will just choose two combinations from here, maybe these two, and OK, and here. Now if I go to the combination list, instead of the previous one, we have these two combinations. Now the problem with this combination is that we have just retrieved the combination. And if you see this dead, the names given here, dead load, live load, wind load, these are not assigned to any of the load cases that we have created. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to assign these loads created here in the combination list to the load cases that we have created. Okay, so now as we do not have the individual loads, we cannot do that, right? So what I will do in the 3D structure, I will show you how you can do these things actually. So I will just cancel it now. In the 3D structure, I will just in a while, let me just finish it. And so we have the combinations already created here. We do not need this actually. Yeah. So let me delete this also. Yeah. So we have these combinations for the design, and we have not given any load factor, just to show you. This is for the presentation purpose. So what I will do, I will go to steel now. So now here we are going to design the steel sections here. So for designing the steel section, first we have the default parameters. So if I click on this default parameter, you can see some general definitions you have to keep here as per the code you are using. The allowable deflection, the allowable slenderness for compression and tension here. Okay, the tension area, whether you want to use the 100% of the gross area. Then the steel grade. We have some predefined steel grades, or if you want, you can define your own steel grade, like as a user-defined grade actually. And what are the sections you have, whether you want to use those sections as hot rolled, or you want to design those sections as cold form. Okay, so you can see here, I have chosen here cold form sections. Then we have design code. Now this design code is for hot rolled sections. And if you go to this cold form, this is for cold form sections. So in one model, you can design two type of things actually, hot rolled and also the cold form sections. So suppose as we have only cold form sections in this wall panel, maybe I will be choosing this one, AISI specification, allowable stress design. You can also see we have this strength increase due to forming. This is as per the code. If you want, you can choose it here and you'll get to know in your throughout the course actually. And I will just click on OK after this. Then we have sections. Yes.
Yeah, this code only American and Euro code is available.
Yeah, till now we don't have Indian code actually, but the developer team is working on that and very soon we'll be having Indian code also.
Okay.
Yeah. Now another very important thing is this section. If I click on this section, here we have two options. One is check the specification specific section which is assigned in the geometry. Like it is asking you whether you want the software to check the sections you have assigned here, or whether you want to, like, you want the software to choose the type of section that you have assigned as per the requirement. So we have these two options. If you assign this, it will check only the section which is defined here, or you can say assigned here, whether it is passing or failing. Or if you select this, select best section from type given in the geometry, and if you choose the cold form section list, the software will check one by one all the sections available, but it will not assign the random type of section. Whatever type, suppose I have assigned C-lips here, so it will only assign the C-lip sections only, not maybe Z section or something like that. It will not assign such random sections. Okay, so for now I will just go with this assigned in geometry and all beams, obviously. Another option, we have this identical section. So it will be used only when you are asking the software to choose the section for you. Okay, why? Because suppose, just let me cancel it. Suppose you have this section, and for the upper one, it is choosing some higher section, and for the lower one, it is choosing some lower section. So in real field, it is not possible. You cannot provide like this, right? So what you want in cold form sections, actually cold form structures, like we always want a similar type of sections throughout here. So what it will do, if you click on this identical section and maybe select by property number, you can select these properties. So the software will assign the similar kind of sections given. Suppose here, if it is C-lip 7541, here also, if the requirement is C-lips maybe 75 or maybe something around 71, 41, something like that, it will choose the higher one, which is assigned at the top. Okay, to make it a similar for you, because it is not obviously not possible in the real case to assign different sections for one particular member here. Okay, so this identical section is useful there. For now, as we are going to check only the assigned section, so it is not required. Then we have these parameters. Now in this parameters, these are already there, but the most important thing in this parameter is this effective length. So you can ask the software whether you want to consider or you want to calculate the kx values. Like do not change means it will take the default value of 1. Otherwise, you can choose two options here. We have a value of kx is defined directly. You can define your kx value as per your codal provision. Otherwise, you can compute or you can ask the software whether this frame is braced frame or unbraced frame. Depending on the type of frame, it will consider the kx values actually. But for now, I will just click on this do not change the kx value. So it will consider the default value of 1 for this frame. Okay. And here you can see do not change. You can also choose these options to calculate the kx values, k and kx and ky values actually. Okay. And another option we have here, which is you can see here, I think. Let me just see.
So this software chooses the effective length by default, or we have to provide the effective length?
No, effective length will be calculated by the software itself. But this effective length factor, when you are choosing this, do not change the kx value, it will consider 1. Otherwise, depending on the type of the structure or type of the model you have selected, maybe braced frame or unbraced frame, it will consider automatically. Or if you want to, yes, sir.
So that we have to give every time, right? Whether it is braced or unbraced, that we have to specify the effective length.
Yes, exactly.
It will the factor it will take from the code, but we have to tell that software that this is braced and this is unbraced.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
Okay.
Or else if you want to, like if you suppose after choosing this, if you are not like satisfied with the values or with the result, you can choose your, you can see the value of kx defined directly. Some people want their user defined value, so you can always give your value here actually. So these three, four options we have available in Strap.
Wind load, can you show us how wind load is applied and earthquake load is applied in Strap?
Yeah, for that I will show in the 3D model actually. Here in the 2D model, we have what we have done. If you see here, we have just assigned the wind load in terms of UDL load here. Calculating the member force for the wind, we have just assigned it as a member load. But how we can do that automatically using the software itself, I will show in the 3D model. So I'm just going through the basic things available in the software so that it will be very easy to understand in the 3D model also.
There is one interesting chest load. I have not seen that. That chest load is there on your right hand side. Some below the moving load, there is some chest load.
Yeah, this one, sir.
Yeah, so I don't know what is the significance of this. What type of load is this? Like dead oblique live load. So it is a combination of the two, dead load plus live load.
Yes. Actually, maybe if you see here, the chest load here, like the dead load, I think I have not used it actually yet. Maybe this is used for bridges, but I'm not sure about it. I will let you know, sir, actually. I'm not sure about it. But in normal structures, I have not used this staggered load option till now. So
yeah,
I'm not sure about it. Yeah. So I'm just, let me just go to steel again. Then, so we have explained the parameters. Now we have the supports and the combined beam, which is very important. Now here at the top chord, this is a 2D panel, wall panel, but this wall panel will be a part of a 3D structure. And as I have told, at the top, we will be having this the joists, or again the floor joists. So in that case, if I talk about the buckling of this member, as we have these joists at the top in the real case, so it will be at this direction, it will be from one joist to another joist, the buckling. In the other direction, it will be for as a whole section. So this thing, as we have not considered here, or as we have not modeled here, so the software will not consider. For that, we have these two options. One is supports, and another one is combined beam. Now, the combined beam is a different thing, but if I talk about the support, Here, what you can do, you can assign the restraints actually at the top. Okay, so what I will do, let me just uncheck this. So previously we have assigned the loads at the position of the joist, right? So here you can see, if I click on this major axis restraint, you just have to see whether which axis is restrained. So I have selected this major axis restraint here for this member. And we have this option, support at all concentrated load points. Like previously we have assigned the concentrated loads or joint loads. So at these locations, the support will be assigned. So if I click on this support, and if I click on maybe select by window, and I will select this beam. Now you can see the supports are assigned automatically here. Now the software will consider that here we have this lateral restraints, and now accordingly the buckling of this member will be happening. Otherwise it will consider like from this node to this node. But in between we have this joist, obviously it will be a different thing, right? So this thing we need to assign using this support. And another option that we have here, the combined beam, this is for these, maybe this vertical or this horizontal members. Let me explain in one case. Suppose this horizontal member, and we have in between, like we have created two beams here, right? If I just click on here, so, you can see.
Basically, yes. Basically, you are talking that these are acting as secondary beams, right? Those load points that you have provided. But what we generally do that we in regular structures, the secondary beams are released, and the main beams are not restrained for that direction. So if you consider these as a secondary beams on a main beam, so secondary beams are perpendicular to this beam. That are connected to the process, right? And that are supported at this point. So that that point, joint load, point load you have provided at these points, right? And there will be a truss or a beam on the other side. So basically it will be a frame on the other side, and this is just the wall.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, so that is so, why you have provided this. So that is correct from that respect. And if it is a secondary beam, then this will not be required.
As I was explaining,
this is the secondary beam, and the main beam is on the perpendicular side, and that's why we are releasing the secondary beam. Yeah, okay. So somebody may confuse in this regard. So this is a good option available here.
Another very, very good thing that or you can say good option available in STRAP is this combined beam option. Now it is pretty clear for us. If you see these outer members in the real structure will be having the lateral supports from this direction, right? So obviously if you see the buckling of this member, the flexural buckling, it will be from this node to this node like this. But if you see this internal members of this wall panel, there is no lateral support. If you see, if you just imagine this as a part of the 3D structure, so here there will be no lateral support from the other direction, from the perpendicular direction. So when you will be seeing the buckling of this member, flexural buckling, it will be from this node to this node like this as a whole. So that's why what we have done, we have option to combine, because we have created two members here. And if I do not assign anything, or if you do not tell the software that these two will be working as a whole one member, then the software will consider these two as a single individual member, and the buckling, or you can say the effective length, will be considered as from here to here for this member, the member number 29, and for 28 it will be from here to here. But that we do not want for this intermediate members, right? So that's why what we have done, If you go to this combined beam options, we have option to define. If I click on this by start and end of the beam, we have option to just provide support for major axis bending, for minor axis bending, or for major axis buckling or minor axis buckling. So what we have done, we have restrained the minor axis here, because this section, depending on the orientation of the section, we have restrained the minor axis of this member. Okay, now just if I run the analysis, you will understand that what this thing will be working here. Same here for this beam. We have two beams here. So obviously, if you see here, we want this beam to buckle like this. Okay, but as we have created two beams here, we have to provide something here that the software should consider these two beams as single beam while checking the buckling of this membrane. Okay, or while considering the you can say the effective length of this membrane. Now I will just show you for comparison between this member and the member here, internal member, where we have assigned the combined beam option, or you can say we have assigned the restraint here. So I will just turn off the beam number and I will click on compute for all beams. So this is the summary result. I will come back to this result again. I will just close it. Now, just to show you the difference between these two, what I will do, I'll right click on this member and I'll click on this detailed result for beam 34. You can see it is considering the length of the member, effective length of the member, as 1.70. And if you see the KX and KY value, as I have said, we have selected do not change. So it is considering the default value of 1 here. Okay. Now, here these two members are combined, right? So if I click on this and click on detailed result for beam number 29. Now you can see here it is considering the effective length as 3.50. That means from this point to this point as a whole. So this is the reason we need to assign this combined beam. Now, actually, in 2D frame, as we have not modeled the lateral restraints, that's why we cannot ask the software to apply these things automatically. But in 3D frame, the software can do that automatically, as we will be creating all the members present in the model. Okay. So now what I have done, I have just completed the design. And if I go to results, and if I click on this display result summary, so this is the summary actually that we have just seen in a while ago. So if you see this, the number of members, okay, and all of the axial forces, the shear parameters, like the shear forces, okay. And it is very clumsy to understand all these things, but it is always better to see the detailed report. For that, you can click on any of these members, maybe this one, and right click on this detailed result for beam number 35 for all design combinations, or maybe the design combinations only. Show maximum result and click on OK. Now you can see a detailed result, design result for this particular member. So this is the effective length calculated by the software, the section that you have considered, what are the sectional parameters or sectional properties calculated by the software itself.
This KX can you and expand,
yes.
Can you expand this report?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Actually, it will come up to here only. So is it okay, sir, now? Because if I expand also,
it is visible.
Okay, so here you can see the moment, the major moment on the section, and in all these design forces, or you can say the results will be tabulated so that you can understand. And this is the utilization ratio actually.
I think this is the best thing I have seen in any software as compared to StatPro or any other software. This is quite good in terms of the analysis or the design that they have done. If they give this type of report, it will be easy for the reviewers to check.
Yes, exactly. So yeah, this is for now. What we have done, we have selected for the critical design combination. You can see this, the same result for all other combinations actually. If I right click and detailed results, and I will click on all combination, so it will show the same for all combinations available. So you can see combination one, the forces, the result, combination two. So like this, it will show for all the combinations actually here. So we had only three combinations, so it is showing for three combinations. Now, so you have got the idea about how you can check the results. Another thing, another way of checking the result, or you can see the capacity of the members. So if I click on result and display capacity, I can click on this color by capacity and the percentage of the capacity. Now, capacity for which force, maybe the axial force plus moment for the moment, or maybe maximum of all results. It will show you whichever is critical actually. Okay, so it will show you the capacity in terms of the maximum one. So if I click on this, you can also exclude or include the slenderness. So I will include the slenderness and click on OK. So now you can see the capacity of the member, or you can see the utilization percentage actually. And these colors actually you can change. There is no hard and fast rule. You can always change these colors here. You can see the colors here defined for different percentages. So you can choose, you can change these percentage values also for as per your requirement. And you can see the result as per the, like, whatever as like you want actually. So this was all about a 2D, or you can say a 2D cold form wall panel design. Now, after designing, what you can do, you can check, or you can optimize the section. Like how to optimize, I have already explained here. Like the software will automatically choose the best section, which is good, like available for you actually. Another way, we have not checked the structure or the wall for sway. So what you can do here, you can see we have this sway option. Now, why it is showing the result? Because in the previously, I have already selected one point for the sway check. So let me just show you how we can do that. So if I go back to the loads panel again, and we have this option called sway. If I click on this, you can see the sway for node number 3 is already defined here. So I will just turn on the node number so that it will be easy for you to understand. You can see the node numbers. I will go back to the sway option. I will click on add. Now, here we have two options, whether you want to check the drift or whether you want to check the sway of the structure or of the member. Now, in which direction, whether it is X1 or X2? If it is X2, obviously it will be the bending of the beam, or maybe deflection of the beam, not bending, it will be deflection of the beam. And if it is X1, then obviously it is the lateral sway of this wall panel. So if I click on this X1, okay. Now it will ask you to choose any of the point at which you want to check the sway. So previously this node number 3 was selected. Now I will check this 24. Now you can see two nodes are assigned here for the sway check. I will end this and I will just solve it again. And I will go back to the steel. Here, I will go to this sway, and you can see display sway values for current sections. So with the current section that you have assigned for this, this is the sway we are getting, 1.46 mm and 1.43 mm at node number 3 and 24. So this way you can also check what is the sway for the lateral loads you are getting in your structure. You can also see what is the total weight, or what are the sections assigned in the structure. If I go to results and if I click on this, you can say display section summary. So these are the type of sections assigned in the structure, and this is the total weight of the structure. Okay, so for individual also, for all the section, sections, we have these weights, and we are also getting the total weight of this wall panel. So this way we can design a 2D wall panel in Strap, and the similar way we can similar process we can assign, or you can apply in the 3D structure also. Just let me open one 3D structure for your understanding. So you can see the similar way we have created this 3D, and the wall that I have showed. So this is the wall actually, right? We have modeled there. So this kind of wall individually we have created, and we have designed individually. Also, you can do that in a 3D model. Now, in the 3D model, I will not show all the things. I will just directly go to the loads and about the wind load. So if you see this, the wind load, existing wind load, you can see wind in the direction x2 plus with pressure inside and suction inside. So these things are actually not defined by you. In the software, we have option to define these things actually. So how to do that? Again, there is always the option is available to assign this as global load. Like you can calculate by yourself using manual method and you can assign this. Otherwise, we have this option called wind load here, which will help you to assign the wind load automatically. I will go to the wind load and I'll click on define new wind load. The height direction, now here you can see the global axis, and here we have three axes, x1, x2, and x3. X3 is the height direction, so I will choose this x3, and I will click on what type of loaded area we have. This is a building contour and roof, so I will click on this. Now, on which member you want to assign the wind load? Obviously, I want to assign the wind load on beams. Okay, so I will click on OK now. I will just give it a name, maybe wind x1, maybe 01. Click on OK. Now, what is asking? Here you can see in the left-hand side corner, it is asking you to choose the base level and start the contour. So what you have to do, you just have to give the base of the structure. Okay, so I will choose a point here. And automatically it will come here actually at the base of the structure. So you have to create the contour like this. Now it is asking you to end the definition of the contour. Now see, in some structures we have podiums with a larger area, and after that we have the tower with smaller area. In that case, contours will be different. But here in our structure, all that whole structure is of same size, right? The same contour we have. So in that case, you do not have to add. You can see here more contours in same level if you want, or new contour at the top level, you can do that actually. But here I will just click on this end building contour definition. Now it is asking what type of roof you have. Flat roof, mono pitch roof, you can see, or duo pitch roof, or multi-span roof you have. Or you want to ignore the roof for wind calculation. So we have a duo pitch roof. So we'll select this duo pitch roof. In which direction you have the roof, the ridge direction? So in that case, in our case, it is in X1 direction. So we'll select this global X1. You can see this ridge of the structure, the truss. Then these are as per your code, you can define the CP values. We have upward value, we have downward value of CP. You can also choose the internal coefficient here, maybe 0.5, like plus 0.5, minus 0.5. All of you know about this if you have idea about the wind load. Then you can choose what type of roof it is. Roof is in partially enclosed building. So I will choose this one only because this is not an open building, obviously. It is a partially enclosed building. And I will maybe click on end here. So now it is asking you to select a node on the ridge. So I will select this node here. Now here we have to give the parameters as per the code we want to choose actually. So let's choose the code first. I will click on code. Here, these are the codes available for the for defining the wind load. So we have Euro code, we have IS code, we have Australian New Zealand code, we have AAC, Canadian code, Israel code. So all these codes are available for the definition of wind actually. For now, I will choose IS 875 and maybe I will go with the default parameters only, class 3, category 2. Okay, this K3, K4 here you can put as per the code. And once you change this velocity, maybe I will just choose it, maybe 50 meter per second. So automatically the pressure will be calculated. You can see if I change it to 47, you can see the pressure value is changing. Now you need to choose the direction of wind. So I will choose plus X1. Okay. Now it is asking whether you want to assign or you can create any other wind load case or not. So I will just click on no now. And now I will show you how it has assigned the wind load here. So I will go to existing load. And if I go to wind X101, you can see the windward face, obviously. Sorry, just let me click on this. The windward face, the leeward face, the side walls and the roof. So all the directions automatically it has calculated the wind pressure as per the definition that we have given. So I hope it is pretty clear how easily we can, like, it is a pretty tedious task to calculate all these things automatically. Some people used to ignore also the side faces, but here using this automatic definition option, you can do that in just a minute. So is there any doubt regarding this wind load? I hope it is pretty clear. Let me. Hello.
Yeah, anybody has a question, they can raise the question.
Okay, I think no one have question regarding this. Should I continue, sir?
Yeah, please.
Okay. So this is the way of defining the wind load automatically in the software. Now we are left with the earthquake load. So for earthquake loads, the first thing is we need to assign the weights, or you can say the static load of the structure. So once we are done with load, defining the loads, the dead load, live load, and wind load here, we can solve it and we can go to this weights option. If you see the weights. Now here I have already assigned the weight. How to assign the weight? You just have to click on this static load. And you can choose the loads you want to add as the seismic weight. So what I have done, I have created one load case named as total dead load. And I have given the factor as 1 for 100% dead load. And for all the wind loads, live loads, I have considered 25% live. So you can define this load factors. And you can choose in which direction it should be actually in the all nodes. So if you click on this all nodes, so automatically the static weight of the structure, you can the seismic weight of the structure will be calculated. After that, you can go to the mode shapes. You can select here how many number of mode shapes you want. You can select the height direction. And here you can choose X1, X2, like these are the horizontal directions for us. And if you want to also consider the vertical direction, you can also choose this X3 option. And here, these are the eccentricities, the design eccentricity as per the code you can select. Now, suppose you do not have the eccentricity same for all the floors, right? So what you can do, you can also change this, like you can assign this to different floors also. If you click on this eccentricity, so floor wise, you can assign the eccentricities actually here. Okay, for X2 direction first. Then after that, for X1 direction like this, you can choose the eccentricity actually. So now, for now, I will not consider the eccentricity. I will just choose X1 and X2 direction. Number of modes, 15, okay. You can also check the soft story if you want. For now, I will just, for time, it will be a bit time consuming to calculate, so I will not consider now. So I will just click on okay, and I will solve it. So this is, here we have this one solution. Like you can actually define multiple type of mode, like modal definitions, and you can solve. I'll click on solve. And you can see we have defined 15 mode shapes, right? So it is solving all the 15 mode shapes. Now you can see the deflected shape, or you can see the mode shapes, mode 1, mode 2, mode 3. Like all the mode shapes you can check. So this is the visual representation of your mode shapes. You can also see in the tabular form. If I go to draw modes, sorry, not here, display table, and here you can see display modal result. So you can see we have the 15 number of modes, total mass participation 0.785. Okay, so it is only 78%. You can also, I will show you how you can actually resolve this issue. So here only we are getting 78%. So what we need to do, we need to change the number of modes. We need to increase the number of modes. Otherwise, in the seismic parameter, once we are done with mode shapes, what we can do, we can go to dynamics. We are already in the dynamics. I will go to seismic analysis, method for combining modes. And here we can, you can see we have two methods. One is SRSS, another one is CQC. And you can always choose this option. Always add missing mass correction to the combinations. So whenever you have this missing mass in that case, or maybe the mass participation is not up to the mark. So in that case, it will take care of that. Sir will explain you through in your course regarding this actually. So I will not talk about more. So in the software, we have this option automatically, missing mass correction actually. So, and you can see the maximum frequency, cutoff frequency 33, we have this. And any of the methods you can choose from here, SRSS or CQC for combining the mode shapes. So one thing I want to clear about this, in STRAP, we don't have actually static method of earthquake analysis. We don't have that option. As in most of the areas, people are using the dynamic analysis nowadays. So in STRAP, we don't have this option for like calculating the static, you can say doing the static analysis for the structure. Okay, so you only have the dynamic analysis option.
For industrial structures, we only have to do dynamic analysis. So okay. For industrial structures, we do not have option to do static method mostly.
Okay.
So part four, it relies more on the dynamic analysis. So for that, I think this is representing that industrial structures. It could be having more. And this rigid diaphragm, so is it considering rigid diaphragm right now?
Yeah, even if you do not assign this, it will consider automatically actually. So you have option to define like user defined, assign the user defined diaphragm. If you are not defining, so depending on the nodes available in the different flow levels, it will create the rigid diaphragm actually. So there is no issue, it will consider automatically.
Okay. So,
Now if I go to we have already solved the mode shapes. Now we need to define the seismic parameters. So if I go to seismic analysis, and here you can see we have this edit spectra. You can choose, like, now the software is using this response spectra El Centro. You can always change it. And obviously it will be changed as per the parameters you will be assigning here. Like, it will match with the parameters here. So if I click on this parameters, you can select the code here for the seismic parameters. So if I click on this select another code, you can see we have Israeli standard, we have user defined response spectra that we can see here. The UBC 97, we have Euro code, Indian code, NBC, and obviously the AAC standard we have. So for now, I will choose Indian standard IS 1893-2016, the updated one. And here we need to, as we'll be doing the you can say dynamic analysis, obviously the mode shapes are very important in that case. So you can choose the number of modes. So I want all the 15 modes to be incorporated. The direction of earthquake, maybe X1. Soil type you can choose from here. The importance factor, response reduction factor, and the seismic zone factor. Okay, so these things are pretty simple to understand, I, R, and Z, which is given in the code IS 1893. Now here we have two options. One is no scaling, another one is scaling. So if I choose no scaling, the software will give you the base shear only for the dynamic force, or you can say the dynamic response factor. And if I choose scaling, then in that case, one thing we need to define, which is this time period as per the code, the empirical formula given in the code. The total seismic weight will be calculated automatically by the software as per the definition of seismic weight that you have already given previously. So this time period you need to consider here. Maybe I will just change it to maybe 0.4 second, something like that. Okay. And if I click on, I will just first go with no scaling and click on OK, and I'll update the result. OK, let me just solve it in the load. Dynamic. Yeah, so here you can see the dynamic direction one, X1 we have done. How many mode shapes we want from 1 to 15, obviously, and I will click on OK. And previously it was available in my model, so I'll just replace it. Okay. Now, if you want to see the result for the particular definition we have done now, so I will just go to display table, display modal results. Okay. So now you can see the CQC result. It is showing you 0.83. Okay, so this is the base shear, a kilonewton actually. This is the base shear for only the dynamic force. And you can see the response spectra graph here. I don't know why it is showing like this. Okay. Okay, maybe because I have not calculated the time period. It was 0.4 I have considered. So depending on that or the response reduction factor, all these things are very important to get the proper result actually. So depending on those values that I have assigned, it is giving me the base shear as 0.83. Now, what I want to show you that this 0.83 is only the dynamic base shear. Now, if I go to the update result again, if I go to the parameters again, and if I choose scaling, and if I just give a random value of the time period and click on OK, and I will just update the result again, replace. Display table. Okay, now you can see the CQC result, that is the base shear, you are getting 1.5. So that means this 1.55 is the scaled base shear. So this is your static base shear that you are getting from the software. So what software has done, depending on the time period and the seismic weight of the structure, so it has already multiplied the multiplication factor VV by VV automatically. You don't have to do that manually. And it is giving you the scaled base shear of your for your seismic definition.
So this is an important factor, that in which the scaling is done as per the time period rather than VB bar upon VB factor. Right. So you give a time of, let's say, 0.4 seconds. And right now my dynamic time period is, let's say, 0.9 seconds. And I want it to 0.4 seconds as per my static time period. So this is a very good option as compared to other softwares, because other softwares are not matching time period. They are matching the base shear. Here it is matching the time period of the dynamic analysis with respect to the static time, empirical time period.
So exactly.
That is one difference that we can see here.
And you can also see what is the scaling factor used by the software. So this is 1.8684, 100% scaling. You can also reduce this 100% scaling actually, maybe if you do not want. And yeah, this is the result for the scaled response spectra. And this is the base shear actually. So this is how you can do the seismic analysis also. And as I have told you before, to create the, if I go to results, to create the combination, now I will just show you here. I will retrieve some combination here, standard combination library, retrieve. Maybe these three, okay. And now if I go to the combination list, here you can see these three combinations are there. Previously also we had some combinations, but now again I have assigned these three. Now the problem is these parameters like this dead load, live load, as I've explained already, these are not available in our definition, load definition. So the software has retrieved from the library it has. So what we have to do, we have to assign these particular loads in the combination library with the load we have defined in the software. Okay, so to do that, I will just click on OK. Here you can see we have this option called group. So if I click on group, and if I click on add revise a group, here you can see you can choose this the loads in the design combination. So suppose I want to assign the dead load of design combination to the dead load that I have assigned, I have created in the software. So I'll click on this dead, name will be obviously dead, and here you can see these are the load list that you have created. So what I have done previously, I have assign the total dead load under this load group, which is the dead load that we have here we have in the combination list. So that's why it is yes. Suppose you do not want to add this, you can just click this, and maybe you can click only individually all the dead loads like this, self weight like this. So to make our job easy, I've just created one load case called total dead load, combining all the dead loads, and you can just click on yes for this. Now what the software will do, the software will connect the load case defined in the library here. You can see the total dead load with the load case defined in the combination library. So if I go to results and combinations with this dead load here, then only you can get the result, right? Otherwise, these are just letters written here, or you can say words written here. These have no work. So these are the predefined values. You have to assign these load cases to the defined load case. So these are the defined load case you can see. So we have not provided any factor for this because we have assigned these load groups to the load cases. Okay, so this is very easy. You do not have to create load combinations one by one again and again. You just have to add the load groups to the load cases. That's it. So and if I go to steel, just to show you one last thing, if I will not show all these things because these are already explained. I will click on this combine beam. And now suppose I will just delete all beams. Here you can see we have created almost this. Let me delete the supports also, delete all supports. Okay. So as we have modeled all the lateral supports, all the members here, you can see at the top of the wall, the truss. So in that case, if I click on this combined beam, and here we have this automatic option, defined all sections. So now in that case, there is no issue. It will automatically understand in which direction you have the restraints, which one is internal member, which one is external member, and it will provide the combined beam command, or you can say the end conditions accordingly. Okay, so again, just to show you, if I compute this. Now here we have this wall, this panel, this vertical member and the internal vertical member. So I'll right click this detailed. So as before, it is showing, you can see it is 1.17, the effective length. And if I choose the internal member and right click detailed result for beam, it is giving you, sorry, not this one. I think I have chosen the wrong one. Let me just move it a bit here. Here you can see it is giving you 3 meter. So 3 meter was the total height of my cabin. So for this internal member, it is choosing the, or it is defining the effective length from here to here as a whole. And for this outer members, as we have this lateral restraints or lateral members from here. So in that case, it is considering like from this point to this point. So this way the buckling will be happening. So it is considering the effective length here. So this is the beauty of this TRAP 2021, or you can see the other versions also we had such advanced options actually, that most of the things will be done by the software itself. We just have to recheck whether the things which the software have assigned, it is correct or not. And I've already showed you that it is considering how it is considering the effective lengths. I hope it is pretty clear to all of you. You can also check the rendered view. I will just show you. This is the rendered view. And if you want to check in color, so these colors are assigned depending on the sections you have assigned. So it is, even these are pretty like if you want to do any presentation, you can take the screenshot of it and you can present it properly. So this is all about STRAP 2021 used for LGSF design, like design of LGSF structures. So if you have anyone have any doubt or any have any query regarding this, they can ask now. Hello, am I audible, sir?
Yeah, we have Mr. Ganeshan here. If he can give some feedback on the STRAP 2021. Mr. Ganeshan is online. Okay, we have Mr. Sayed with us. Sayed Kashyap. Okay, so I don't think any query is there right now. So as they will see the session more and more, they may reach you for the doubts.
Yeah, always. Like whoever is like interested to get this software, we also have the 60 days trial license. So you can always check it in the RAMCADS website, www.ramcads.in. Or we do have some sessions in our campus website also. So you can visit our campus website also. And you can always contact with me. Sir will give you the contact details for me so that you can get the idea, or if you want any details regarding Strap for maybe for the purchase or for the use, you can always contact me for this.
Yeah, okay. Okay, thank you, Mr. Sandeep, for this detailed explanation. Each
thank
and
you,
everything you have explained. Yeah, I hope when people will see it again, they will be able to understand more use of it.
Exactly. Yes. Thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, Kamal bol raha hu, sir. G Matrix ke baare mein thoda sa bataiye, sir.
Actually, G Matrix software is also used for cold foam, but it is mainly specifically made for pre-engineered building structures. So if you want to design pre-engineered building structures easily, or you can say in efficient way, so G Matrix 7 is one of the tool using which you can do that actually. But yeah, pre-engineered G Matrix is also used for cold foam, also used for RCC, but the specialization of that software tool is on PEB structures. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Dekha tha maine uska video, sir. Acha hai.
So yeah, you can also try G-Matrix also. G-Matrix is also a good software for PEB structures. You can generate the details, detailed drawing, design reports, everything for that.
Okay, so any question on Strap 2021? As such, we have seen all these things, and I think the seismic analysis that is a different segment in this, which is important
yes,
for
right.
All type of structures. I think that is the and missing mass participation factor. I have not seen in any of the software. It is available only here. That is the missing mass participation factor. We can use the missing mass participation here. So I think that is for seismic analysis and for bridges and for pre-stress structures, for RC structures, I think there are many options.
Yeah, any kind of structure actually can be designed in Strap. Like whether it is RCC, steel, hot rolled, cold form, timber, this is also available actually.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Sandeep.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so yeah, Mr. Umesh, you would be giving something on this for the Vortex PD.
Hello, all of you. Umesh here. Okay, so I won't take much time about Vortex PD. So I will explain how the software works, how the features are there, so what are the new updates and what are the capabilities and all those things. So we'll look into now. Okay, just give me a moment.
Let me give you the option to present.
Okay.
Yeah, you can now present.
Whether my screen is visible, Sandeep, can you confirm?
Yeah, your screen is visible, yes.
So by the name slide looking vertex systems. I think now it is visible.
Yes, sir, visible.
Visible. Okay, fine. Okay, good evening all of you. Myself, Umesh. I am associated with RamCatsys Private Limited. So I'll be taking care of this Vertex PD software. So here are a very few glimpses of what we can say, what exactly Vertex PD. So that is BD means it is a building design. So end of the day, so BD. So how it will work? So what are the codal provisions are available, how things will be carried out, and it is how to detailing work and everything will be done, and how after the extraction of drawings how it will be going to look, and where is precisely it has used and from where it has started. So that everything we will look. So Vertex PD. So we are operating Argosa systems by different name in different countries. So whole world we are 7 distributor including RamCatsys. So we'll be taking care of APAC, Asia Pacific Continentals, and it is a one-stop solutions for what we can say BIM. So now the trend is there. So Yoran is asking, sir, it is coming, and it is not a boom, it is exactly where exact next level of industry. So it is a digital construction industry. So next level of changes which will very soon it is going to happen now after 2021. So already a lot of people have seen many other competitive softwares like Autodesk, Bentley. So everything coming in one-stop solutions from scratch to the what you can say that a cloud solutions in that manner. So the Vertex PD also does. So it is we can do the architectural design and core form steel as well as hot rolled steel framing designs. Even it has timber framing and HRS, that is hot rolled steel. And it has automation of CNC machine where so the provision of so what are the things you have designed or developed by using steel design or either it may be timber. So you can send it directly to the CNC manufacturing machine. So that automation is available. And so as I said, it is a building information model. So here we can do in the there were 8 parameters, we can say that, or 8 major things where we can do. So in that, first it comes, it starts with the framing design, then it's architectural design, and IFC compatibility with the other software also, where you can import and export IFC also, and drawing generation, CNC manufacturing and automation, which I have said already. And you can convert the file, do the file conversion to IFC, DXF, DWG, PDF also. And so we can prepare your project model as a sales tool, so which will help over your marketing, so you can generate the that video also. So this is how exactly. So just 4 pictures are there. So when after using Vertex PD architectural design, so we can generate files like this, and we can create views like this also. So this is a very quick example of framing, how the framing can be done, how the results. So results will be in the form of what you can say that Excel sheet also, which we can send to factory or which we can send to the manufacturers directly. So for this stages of steel, so this kind of material and everything, sizes and everything, and the courses, everything is available. And it has a total wall layer control, so we can create a walls, so in between, so which is light gauge steel frame, what we are talking from last 1 hour. So this kind of flooring also we can create. And this is completely hot rolled steel, one example, connections we can do, and wall layer controls, everything can be done. And here it is a new tool, we can say that Vertex Showroom, so which will help to link the project to teams. So suppose if someone is working on a structural segment, architectural segment, and MEP, so even MEP also available in this newer version. So where we can, you can link the projects, or you can share the projects in between the team, and you can complete the project as quick as possible. And you can generate for different entities or the different what you call as bars or beams, and we can create a QR codes for that one. We can say that in barcodes, so which will help you to identify very easily. So that is another extra feature which it is going to help for all the modelers or the architectures or the designers to develop very quick and schematic drawings. And BIM project data can be viewed, and same we can edit and we can upload that one. It's all about vertex systems, how it will help and all. So now we'll switch to the software. Just a minute. Okay. Can anyone confirm me, Bhushan Sirji, whether my vertex BD software screen is visible?
Yes, it is visible, yeah. 2022
version. Yes, thank you. This is the newer version of the software. So from last in the month of November, it has launched. So I am showing you what is there in this new version. So first we'll start with the file. So here there are as it is same graphical user interface what nowadays software saying, same kind of graphical user interface there. So here will be, you can have the new projects, save as a export, import, print preferences, and you can go for the software version. So here you can import batch import, that is IGS, SAT, STP, and you can import IFC also, projects from VXZ zip files also, and you can directly open the file. And you can, similarly, you can export VXZ files, and you can save in another manner, or you want to print a PDF sets, you can create a different set of PDF, and you can publish directly to the cloud also. So IFC, this is 2x3x4 or 4x3, that newer version is a format option also available. So it's all about very starting point. When we'll start, so when we take the new project, see here it will ask the project ID. So here we have to give the name, so building, so project ID, if you have any project particular, if you are given, so that we can give. So I will give 00 or 01. This is my project ID. And I can give here as a name. Sasmikarashala. Whether you want to work on a local project, whether you want a design stream. And here the templates are available. Template definition module available and parametric. So usually we have to work on the parametric. If you have any already files, local project, you can browse and we can store in, and it's all about your storage, where you have to store, whether you want to make it as a complete template or whether you want to share a document, whether you want to make as a project. See what are the difference between here. So template means, so it is a standard template for you can say that in a 3040 site, or just I'm giving a very layman example, 3040 site or 6040 site, if you want to construct any light gray steel frame building, so if you made a standard format, so wherever will be the, how much will be the built up area. When next time another project comes, if there is a smaller changes or minute changes, are no need of doing the from the work from the scratch. So by using this template, you can edit, you can make a small edit, and you can use this a tool only, or you can use this template as a standard template only. And many companies want to create their standard templates, like Kirby have their own standards, like Gravity Steels, they have their own standards, and Techno Steels and Gemini Steels, these are the companies. So they want to have their own template and profiles, so which will help them in a long term, which will help them to save their time, as well as to showcase them what exactly in the market, so how we are leading the industry. So these kind of many aspects, so this will help. Okay, just I will create, I'll give one more name. Okay, this is all about your project data, project ID. So today the date is 6, so we can change that one. You have customer data, you can select. So here customer name, you can give Windsor. So automatically it has default, it has taken. And fielding site details, if you have any site details, what are the things you will mention? So end of the drawings, in drawing product, you will get all the details over here. description template for steel frame house. You want any extra info, so you can click over there. You can open if you want to know, give any particular name, so that one. If you want to create this one as a master division database, you can do that one also. So this is a template one. You can go and delivery date, when is the delivery date and contact number, so everything can be done. So, and this is a building data, so you can give your description. So here it is readily available. So if you are decided, so it is a 6-bedroom plus 1.5 BA or a 3 BHK or 5 BHK, like that, how we will be planning initially. So here readily available, we can do that one. And style, which kind of style you want, whether you want a first story, three story, or two story plus basement, or three story basement, like that. And how shape you want, I shape or L shape. Okay. Whether you want how much framed up you want, 7500, 7800. So there are readily standard data available. And roof slope 1:15, or these are up to 1:3, it has given. And if you want to go for a basement, just you have to check in. And if you want to create a porch, so you can go that one. And terrace glass. So whether you want to create a terrace as glass, you can select that one also. And house details, how much square meter. So help rooms and volume, how much it is there. Bay window, whether you want a direct one or angled or a polygonal, or whether how will be the kitchen shape, whether you want a L shape or I shape or a U shape kitchen, surrounding and middle, whether the dining table you want. So that kind of. And balcony one, balcony two, balcony. So how much balconies you need. And storage placement, whether you want in the basement, and that is in garage shed, whether it should be attached or house across the yard. And silent slant you want, if you want. And house collections also available, vertex one, vertex two, vertex three. So these are some standard materials, and some sliding materials are our sliding materials. So you want concrete, stone, timber, brick, vinyl. So initially you can set whether if you are going for steel, whether if you are going for concrete. Here only you can make the changes. And room height 2600, 2800 between, so you can change your own. And which kind of room, hip roof, gable roof, mansard roof, and hillside, porch, terrace open, or how much square meter, number of rooms, how much you required, everything. Just you have to mention, it is a complete automation. So we can say that one-stop solutions for not worrying about drawing a small scratch drawing. So how to create, what will be the room dimensions, how to mention. So like how we'll be using in AutoCAD. So that kind of things are not necessary. Bedrooms, how much you want. So these are the things which you can go for, and the connections data. So these are the contact person details. So who will be the sales representative, that it all, again, it is a project information sharing, who is the constructor, who is the architect, that all the information. And this is the engineering data. So standard truss loads, we can give snow load, dead load, top cord and bottom cord, and active truss loads, top cord, bottom cord, how much you want, whether is there any imposed load. So what kind of load, so if it is imposed, and it is in a kilonewton per meter square.
Yes, Mr. Umesh.
Just a minute, sorry.
Yeah, just, I was just requesting if we can finish it in 10 minutes, if possible.
Yeah, I will.
Thank you.
I won't take much. Yeah, just a minute. Just this mouse got stuck. That's it. Okay, so here it has started. So here your floor level are there, ground floor, first floor, second floor. If you add more floors, you will come to know that. So you will be getting third floor, fourth floor, fifth floor, like that. So here are the settings. You will be in left corner, will be sitting structural drawings, structural design settings. You can view the reports and all, everything. Energy calculation also available, sun energy, that all the things which will be calculated. So everything.
So in this embodied energy can be calculated?
No.
Okay.
And so when you have to decide, so you have to start working on a ground floor. So here it is your ground floor. So here, this is a, you can switch in between the framing models and in between architectural model. Sorry, I forgot to explain a few things. So these are the modeling tools. You can directly start creating wall, window, door, floor, ceiling, roof, component, and EOS timber and staircase directly. And these are some arches which you can start directly over a new open or edit data or save as. So these are the view controls, isometric view, or if you want to select by layer wise or all floors and view in 3D, section view, you can create your section and you can get that one. And these are the some what annotation tools. And you can do blink symbols also you can do. So whenever there will be exit, if any blink symbols you want to give exit, so it should be blinking. That kind of arrangements are also available. This is the output tab. So Excel sheets, collect, report, define cross section, your drawing sheets and everything. And these are the rendering tools. And in this, this is a system where you will be having libraries and everything which is already available. You can create Excel lists and wall. See here, framing details, parts you want or automatic execution you want. So all these things are available. And last comes drafting tools. So even you can start with the single line drawings, polygonal shape, rectangular. These are the things. And when it comes, so if we are already AutoCAD file, so is it possible to import this one? Yes, we can. So there is a reference drawings are available. So you can reference drawing or model, you can take whether it is a DXF file or whether it is an AutoCAD file. Just I will take, so it is there in my system. So just we have to go for the shared files. So in that pictures, I am selecting, just I'm changing this one to AutoCAD drawing. So here the tutorial one drawing is available. Just I will open and I will give this as a name, plan one. So select location, user interface, default layers, everything is set. So here if you want to make any changes or whether you want to skip hatches, you can do that one. See, very easily I have imported my model. Okay, for that, if I want to create a walls, so just I will go and select the walls. So it will give some preview images, which kind of walls you can. Just a minute. So it is taking time to create a wall previews. Here, he want sheathing or framing, which kind of walls you want. So exterior walls or interior walls if you're creating. And it has few, you can create, you can customize your own walls also, other walls library. You divider walls if you want to make, you can create our foundation wall library, or else we can say gravity your walls and this one. So to avoid the collapse of soil erosion, so we'll be constructing one more wall. So so that kind of walls we can create. If I select this one here, the views, what are the views changes we can make, will be here. It can be and steel frame, whether you want a steel frame, see steel frame if you want of how much size. So 70 72 92, it is all our exterior walls, 150 mm, 200 mm, 250 mm. So default it is available, thickness also available, top height also available. Just I click OK, then I have to start creating the walls. Just I have completed my walls. See, when you will go to view in architectural view. See, very quickly it has created. Okay. Suppose if I want to make this one as a separate framing, or we can make a panels. So just I have to click here, and just I have to go for a right click, and you can just on a single tool or a single click generate panels. So which kind of panels you want? Interior sheeting, interior buttons, or sliding interior wall panel, or you want to go for advanced one or button weightings, corner details, or attach. So this kind of, and you want IFC properties sets also, you can create here only, and save project on a specific settings. These are the options available. So which will help you to create a panels very easily. So panels I have got created. Okay. Now, so this is about framing. So the pan, after creating panels, I have to create a frame. So frame tricks, tracks and struts, frame openings, frame bracing. So whether you want to single braces plate strut or single brace 45 degrees, single brace plate to blocking, K brace, these kind of braces and everything available. Service holes, anchor, insulation. If you want insulations, and you can select, okay. So whether mineral wool or polishing foam or urethane foam. So these are some descriptions and everything available. So which will help you to create insulation to profile web. If you want to go that one, you can go for S and just a give. So see my framing panels. So that is still the framing panel, which all happened. Okay. So after creating all this design and all, so very quickly I'll be showing how the output will be coming, because another 5 minutes I have. So like this, you have to create multiple floors and multiple walls, and you can create openings also. So here doors, windows, everything is available. So just already in AutoCAD ranks we have. So just you have to click window, and you have to place, and you have to go for a door. Just you have to draw the door. So it's very, very simple.
So, Mr. Umesh, if you can just tell us the list of windows, lighting, or panel, or in the ceiling, what type of ceiling we can provide, or roofing. So what are the types we can provide?
Yes. In roofing, gable, hip, mono, triangle, turret, half hip, L shaped, bay 1, bay 2, bay 3, 4, U line, so eddy slope. These kind of the roofs we can provide. And ceiling, just a minute, just I'm showing.
So studs we can provide on the roof?
Yes. See. Here, cross section 100 mm 100 point gauge, and standard ceilings are available. Pinnacle structure ceilings are available. These are the readily available ceiling module, and you can create as materials, and you can use your customized one. And when it comes to windows, see. Arch topped, B window, diamond window, E window, H window, and I window. So long house railing openings, round window, S window, triangle window. These are the some examples. These are the about standard windows of parametric. So Allen Brothers, which that is having the six kind of. So vertical sliding, sash bar, W 2x3 grills, 2x4 and 2x2, 2x2. And advanced casement window, dual turn, and vertical sliding slash also available. And custom windows, so basic window, just you can take this one as a basic window, and we can create our own customization. We can use that one. So this is all about windows and frames. So doors. So
we can put the furniture also in this.
Furniture is not possible, sir. Furniture, that changes is going on, they are making. So here the doors, standard doors, again, garage doors, UK doors, Allen Brothers doors, Alu front parametric and custom doors. These are the standard available doors. And schedules, you can create the schedules, you can create the reports, everything. So after generating the drawings, which kind of drawings you'll be getting, just I will show, just I've created one PDF, just a minute. Yes.
So these will be BOQ as well as the part mark.
Yes, sir. BOQ, BOM, everything is available, sir. See, sir, after creating the drawings, so we can get the outputs like this, sir. It's a two-page report, and here it is a BOQ, and these are the left. You can create the left elevation, rear elevation, front and side, which kind of elevation we required, and these are the some cut sections, and front view, side views, everything, and these are the different level of on each frame. So how much frames or how much frames we will be creating, how much panels we will be creating. So each panel description it will be giving, sir. So n number of panels also we can create, so there is no limit. So for each and every panels with the description, what are the materials they have used, that everything it will give. So I will show one example, just zooming more. Here description, stud, how much we have used, horizontal bracket, king stud, crippler, header, crippler, and king stud, bottom track, top rack stud, horizontal bracket, brackets, how much you have used, that everything, and the quantity, how much you have to use, and length, what will be the cutting length and wedding length, everything it will give, sir. And it will help to generate side drawings also, shop drawings also, and what you call as client drawings also. So three kinds of drawings it will generate. So for the separate, it will give for the what you call as top chord, bottom chord also it will give. So what will be the web and which number of readily available channels we can use. So it's and end of the day, so quantity 135.7 kg for one panel weight, so which is generated. So after generating drawings, so at the end it will give each panel weightages, so which will help to decide the materials and the cost and everything. And if you mention the price also in the Excel sheet, and it will give cost also. So
okay, here, so weight analysis can also be done here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We can collect, you can create a XML, or you can Excel it, sir. Just if you want to create a report, so here the report sets are available. Here, sir, cost materials, cost doors, cost of the doors, windows, wall panels, general lists, whether you want to go for the separately, floors, wall, ceilings, doors, railings, G4 parts. So we can say more than 200 types of descriptions we can create. Cutting list, roof rafters by panel, and ceiling joists by roof, by Excel sheet, or whether you want to go for other format also. So
can we model the PT systems also in this?
Post tension.
Yeah.
No, sir. PT is not possible, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Here you can collect roof framing, roof layout, so terrain. So many kind of reports we can generate, which will be without any hurdles, or we can say that without any difficulty. So we can, and it will be easily understandable by in the workshop, in a layman person also, without asking again to the engineer or supervisor. So how much length this is, so it is clear indications. And we can create a schedule also, so exterior wall panels, frames, if you are created truss for that also, you can create the schedule and sheet schedule. So here sheet schedules, manufacturing order schedules differently, you can do that one. And after that, we can create the same sheet. If any changes has to going to happen, that we can generate. And the panel drawings, part drawings, and change label. If you want to change the label, that can be done. And panel stacking, so auto, manual, edit panel. So these are the things we can, and long wall labels, everything can be done. And you can go for the renumber. And here the energy calculation is there. Just taking a time.
So this energy calculation is basically regarding what?
It is what we can say that so when will be the sun in a peak movement? So it is in between a 12 o'clock afternoon, 12 o'clock to 4 o'clock. How much will be the energy at that time? How the energy will be consumed? That kind of manner, sir. And what will be the inside energy will be getting, how the sliding will be happening. So consumption of the energy and whether this cold rolled steel, hot rolled steel will going to sustain that one. So that kind of energy calculations it will be giving, sir. Just a minute, it is not taking, sir. Just go. So it's all about this vertex VD and many options are available. And in this recently added parts, so actually part plus is to add a duct component which was under development. Now they have added in this newer version also, which will be used, and you can create a bend pipe, corner connection, stream array, adjust many things, and you can create a very easily, you can create the distance and also, sir, and you have already propel beam, column, plate, U extension, gabler, rafter, corner rafter, everything is available. So just one click, just you have to select where you want to draw. So it will finish and it will help you to finish as quick as possible. Even you can't believe. So that much handy tool Vertex VD systems have developed.
So MEP, HVAC, everything, yes, can, sir, be modeled here.
Yes, sir. Yes, it is available. So if you want to check that one, so just you have to go for the file and here software version. So here everything is available, sir.
Yeah.
That's all, sir. Is there any doubt to the participants? And if you want to know more about this tool and about a training or anything, so I my contact details, our contact details is with Bhushan Sirji. So you can have discussion internally with them. You can approach any time up to morning 10 a.m. to evening 10 p.m. So we'll be happy to guide you, happy to serve you people. And it has, I forgot to mention, it has UK, Australia codes. And other country codes, only three USA standards. So China is there. Three country codes it is available. So slowly in India, LGSF is picking up. And one example which I'm going to give you is Karnataka state government has decided to construct 2,500 LGSF houses. They already built 250 houses in Bangalore, so which by using LGSF method, so and they have used our software, that is Vertex VD, to get done the things.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Umesh. I think it is a very detailed software, each and every part, everything needs,
yes,
to,
sir,
be done, yes, with your oneself. You only can learn, yes, then only it can be done. Yes, so thank, yes, you for highlighting all the important features, and
yes, sir,
I hope the participants will understand the importance of this software. One is the design, and next is the detailing, which is connected, which is a BIM software. So your project team is coordinated with this support, and that is the, I think, the latest trend to have a connection with the team, and everybody knows that what is to be done. Part.
And anytime, sir, if anyone wants to know more about LGSF or whether they want to know for cold form steel or hot rolled steel, so we are always available. We are anytime we can help. So let us know their free time. So no, sir, we need a session on this topic. So is it available? So how the difficulties will place? So, and me, myself, and
I think Mr. Virat Desai has a question.
Yeah.
He has raised,
yeah,
his, please, hand.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, Virat, you have a question?
Sir, am I audible to you?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, please, please, Virat.
Yes, sir, can you please share your contact details with Bhushan sir, so they can send in our WhatsApp group because I'm interested in something area. So I want to discuss you regarding that.
Yeah, yeah. Our contact details is available with our credentials is available with Bhushan sir ji. So you can collect it.
Bhushan sir, please send me on WhatsApp.
Sure, I will do that. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Sandeep ji, you want to add anything before ending the session?
No, it's quite fine. I think we have already got the detailed explanation for both the softwares from me and from you also, and I think I have taken most of the time for this session. Yeah.
So it is already dinner time for your end.
Yeah.
So if you want more session like this, sir, we can connect. Even I am ready to connect any time in this week in the evening again for a 45 minutes or 1 hour sessions.
Sure. And I think we will have a WhatsApp group, we have a Telegram group. So whatever the need is there, we will directly communicate to you. And thank you for showing the interest and taking the time for this detailed session on the two softwares. And we will be uploading this session on YouTube, and it will be available on my channel and your channel. So participants can go through that anytime, and they can contact you for any queries or any special sessions. Also, they can contact you. You have a special course on the SAP 2021 Vertex PD. So they can take your online course that is available on your website. That is MKTC Private Limited campus is there. So that way they can also take that course and understand the software and use them. So thank you. Thank you all for joining.
And, one more thing we forgot to mention. Also, we have what you call as tensor structure design software also. Sorry, I forgot to share that one. So K3 Tent also, we are the all over the world. We are the all over in Asia Pacific region. We are the authorized partner for that one also. So in Gujarat, there are many tensor manufacturing fabricators companies are available. Many are there, sir. So there is a name called K3 Tent. So we are the pioneer seller of that one. Yes, sir. K3 Tent also we have in our bucket, including NanoCAD.
Excellent. So everybody can see the website. I think it is all mentioned on your website. So all type of products, I think it will be available. So they can go to the website and they can contact you. I have the contact details. I will share with them. And
students, those who want to go for the courses and all, so don't know how we can get the softwares and all, everything. No worries about that. So 60-day trial is available. So in that time we can learn very what we call as in a comfortable way. You can learn the course once you take the course, and our Sandeep is a well-structured guy on the strap. So he created the whole content and developed the things. So you will be having a very smooth and trainings. So we are happy to see you again. So thanks for giving us an opportunity to deliver whatever things we'll be doing things.
Yeah, thank you. So I will take one feedback from Mr. Binur if he's available.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Mr. Binur. So you can give some feedback regarding this software that we have seen today.
Yes, sir. Both software are very good. But the second one, actually, I did not get any costing about the foundation. So is it possible to make there?
Yes, sir, it is possible. We can create the foundation also.
Okay.
So MAT foundation. So once you see the more detailed sessions, I think it will require one complete session specific to Vertex PD because it is a BIM tool. And many, many components are there, how to do the rebarring. The whole thing will take some time. So slowly, I think once you have the hold of that 60-day trial version, I think you would be very well versed with that. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Binu. So I think we can end the session tonight. And thank you for joining. And thank you to Mr. Umesh and Mr. Sandeep for giving. Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, bye. So we can say goodbye and thank you.